Our planet is a blue planet. 71% of the Earth's surface is water, but around 97.5% of that water is salt water. Only 2.5% is fresh and drinkable. That's not a whole lot considering how many walks of life need fresh water in order to survive. What if in some way, shape, or form, all the salt water on Earth became fresh water? That is the question we are asking right now on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that asks the fundamental questions of life. I'm Charlotte Jobray. If this is your first time here, hey, how are ya? Would love it if you subscribed and turn on the bell so you never miss one of our videos, and be sure to stick around until the end of our video where we feature some of your comments. So, what if all the oceans became fresh water? An estimated 790 million people, which is around 11% of the total population of our planet, do not have access to clean drinking water. And that's crazy to say because there is so much water on planet Earth. It's just not consumable as salt water. If we found a cost-effective way to convert some of our oceans into fresh water, sure, there would be plenty of drinking water to go around. But all the salt water on Earth being converted into fresh water is another story. It definitely wouldn't be all sunshine and rainbows. In fact, it's likely that most life on our planet would die. But let's not get ahead of ourselves just yet. I will get into that in a couple of minutes. Here's a fun fact. Did you know that all the oceans on Earth used to be freshwater? Well, they did. Yay, facts. Around 3.8 billion years ago, the Earth's surface had finally cooled down, from the rotating liquid magma ball it once was, to the Earth we know today. And water vapor was able to turn from a gas into a liquid. But it didn't stay as fresh water for very long. Shortly after the planet cooled, climactic cycles began. When it rained, carbon dioxide in the atmosphere dissolved into the rain, making the rain acidic. The rocks then started to erode slowly but surely as it rained. Rainwater then crept its way into rivers and streams, loosening the salt and minerals, and the runoff eventually made it into the oceans. Of course, this didn't happen overnight. It took billions of years and countless rainstorms for our salty oceans to become as vast as they are today. Most of the fresh water that's consumed by humans is done so through agriculture. 20% is consumed by industries and 10% is for domestic use. Humans and other animals need water to survive. The average human lives 80 years, and in their lifetime they will drink 87,600 liters. But even though humans are consuming a lot of water, we also need to consume food too. There are so many types of seafood that humans eat that we would no longer be able to if all our oceans became fresh water. I mean, listen, okay, I guess I could live without oysters, but I definitely wouldn't want to. And shrimp, crab, lobster, forget about it. There are around 230,000 marine species that live in the ocean, and scientists think that there could be as many as 2 million species that haven't been discovered yet. But if you take that salt water out of the ocean, all those organisms would die. The organisms that are affected the most are plankton and phytoplankton. They are at the bottom of the food chain, and when you take them out of the equation, the rest of the food chain is affected. Think about the fact that marine microorganisms like algae account for almost half the photosynthesis on Earth. Algae pulls carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and creates a huge chunk of oxygen that we as humans breathe. Things start to get real complicated real fast. If all the oceans became fresh water, it's likely most plants and animals, including humans, would die off real quick. If starvation and suffocation didn't kill you, then everything and everyone that's left would not be living on a recognizable Earth. With no microorganisms in the ocean creating oxygen for us to breathe, there would be an abundance of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. The greenhouse effect would go into overdrive, making many parts of the Earth unspeakably hot, like at the equator, and other parts of the Earth incredibly cold, especially close to the poles. Hurricanes would be a regular occurrence, and they would be much more severe and much more deadly. The global population is growing at an insane rate. By 2050, it's estimated that there will be 9.7 billion people on Earth. The more people on Earth there are, the more fresh water we will need to drink, and the more food that will need to be produced. We are definitely going to need to find a cost-effective way to convert salt water into fresh water. But turning all the salt water into fresh water? Yeah, that's pretty much a death wish, bro. Well, there you have it. You have just heard what would happen if all the oceans became fresh water. Tell us your thoughts down there in the comments. For now, I'm gonna wrap up this video by responding to some comments from my video, What If We Drained the Mariana Trench Part 2? Sam Ameson said, what if Bohemian Rhapsody had never been written? Wayne's World definitely wouldn't be as iconic, that's for sure. Concavenator Production said, we shouldn't drain the Mariana Trench because Godzilla is resting at the bottom. Because logic, right? Who needs logic? You're watching Life's Biggest Questions, remember? Mems God said, I love your voice.
Oh, thank you very much.
That is all for this episode of Life's Biggest Questions. If you enjoyed it, make sure you leave a thumbs up, subscribe, and turn on notifications, and I will see you in a future episode.